Joining us, the Attorney General, today, the person who was perhaps entrusted with the most difficult task. Sir, very quickly, your reactions to all the developments that have come out from the court today.
See, we made it plain to the court that this government is not interested in hiding any name from the SIT or from the court. We were really concerned with the issue of confidentiality, which is a part of the treaties and which have been executed and also those which are going to be executed. But the court first said that you give us the names first. We told the court that the names were given to the SIT and the investigation by the Income Tax Department is under the auspices and under the control of the SIT. And as you know, the SIT was appointed by the Supreme Court. So we were explaining our problem, but the court first said that please disclose all the names of the list which you have obtained from France, that is the HSBC account list. We have no problem in disclosing the names to the court, and we shall be doing that tomorrow morning at 10:30.
Sir, very quickly, you somewhere wanted to retain the aspect of investigation to determine between illegal and legal account holders. You today made a very determined effort in front of the court to try and say as to why this modification should be permitted. It has not been permitted. Instead, we have had some terse observations also coming out from the Supreme Court. How are you perceiving that, sir?
See, it was my duty to point out that investigation was being carried out by the Income Tax Department under the supervision of the SIT. And it is our understanding that if the accounts are found to be legal after investigation, then they should not be disclosed. And that is what para 76 of the judgment of the Supreme Court says, that those disclosures should not be there. But the hearing was inconclusive and the court said you first bring us the names and we shall be producing them to you.
So at one point in time when the hearing was underway today, we also saw you telling the court that if future treaty agreements are not entered into by this country, this court would be to some extent responsible.
Obviously, if we cannot give certificate of confidentiality, a sovereign certificate required under the treaty, that the names will be shared only with the court which is conducting the prosecution. If we can't give that certificate and the names have to be given to others, even without verification that whether accounts are legal or illegal, then obviously the future treaties will be in jeopardy and we have to execute a treaty which will give us huge amount of information under the automatic route, which is you don't have to ask for information, it comes on a daily basis with the US. And that was scheduled to be executed sometime end of this month or December. So if we can't give the confidentiality certification, then we can't enter into a treaty. So I told the court that the court should be cognizant of the fact that this issue may arise. That's all I said.
Sir, are you viewing it as a setback?
There is no question of setback. As I told you, this government does not desire to withhold any name whatsoever. That is how I started my submissions. And we will be glad to give it to the Supreme Court. There is no question about it.
There you have it, the Attorney General telling us about the government's position and stating very clearly that this government is all for disclosing names. In New Delhi, Meenakshi Panjwani, Times Now.